amazingly flexible interior, an efficient powertrain, and agreeable pricing make the Fit an easy recommendation. The 1.5-liter inline-4 makes 130 horsepower when equipped with a standard 6-speed manual, but 128 horsepower when paired to the optional continuously variable automatic transmission. Automated emergency braking, lane keeping assist, and adaptive cruise control are optional. A 7.0-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto is standard on all but the base LX. That's not to say the Fit Sport doesn't feature any performance-improving modifications. It does, but they're shared with the rest of the lineup. All 2018 Fits benefit from a stiffer structure thanks to additional bracing, and Honda has tweaked the steering and suspension in an attempt to impart a sportier character. The engine remains a naturally aspirated 1.5-liter inline-4 churning out 130 horsepower when mated to the 6-speed manual transmission, as it was in our test car. A continuously variable automatic transmission costs $800 extra. Selecting it reduces output to 128 horses. Unsurprisingly, then, the 2018 Fit's performance on our test track differed only minutely from the last manual transmission model we tested. At 8.2 seconds, its 0 to 60 mph time was 0.2 seconds lower than the previous car's, its 70 mph to zero braking distance of 179 feet was 1 foot longer, and it pulled 0.81 grams around the skid pad, besting the 2015 model by just 0.02 grams. The Honda's handling qualities are playful, and the Fit can be tossed into most corners with a touch more confidence than before. While the steering is light and feels limp on center, it provides traces of feedback and weights up slightly as the wheel is turned. For 2018, Honda's engineers layered in more sound-deadening material throughout the car and added thicker glass for the windshield and front side windows, claiming interior noise has been reduced. Our sound testing equipment registered 71 decibels at a 70 mph cruise, 2 higher than the last stick shift model we tested and 2 lower than our 2015 long-term test car. Regardless, when driving at highway speeds, the engine spins at a high 3,500 revolutions per minute, creating a buzzing annoyance throughout the cabin that can grow wearying on long trips. The Fit's claim to fame remains its astonishing practicality. The rear seat, which Honda calls the magic seat, can be reconfigured easily to haul bulky items and features seat bottoms that flip up to create a divided cargo area or flip down to help create a completely flat, very low load floor. In our testing, the Fit provided space for 20 carry-on size suitcases with the rear seat folded in the flat position. The Fiesta and the Rio managed just 14 each. The Sport comes with a $1,310 price hike over the base LX model but brings a 7.0-inch touchscreen infotainment system, up from 5.0 in the base car, with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a 180-watt 6-speaker stereo, a second USB port, fog lamps, and the aforementioned exterior styling bits. Besides the efforts to upgrade the chassis and reduce noise, this mid-cycle update also includes the much-appreciated return of an actual volume knob for the audio system, replacing the fussy capacitive touch slider that so annoyed us during that 40,000-mile long trip.